So good morning class
good
7 children.
morning,
good morning. So today we are going to continue with chapter number 15, light. Now the last part of the chapter is sunlight, white or colored. It's very interesting concept that whenever we see outside, it appears that sunlight is white in color, but actually it is not. We can see different colors in the sunlight also. Now we have to identify, is there any experiment done by the that scientist who can show that sunlight is white or colored. So let's have a look. So Tanvi Bakshi, I know, I want you to read it. Sunlight, white or colored.
Okay, ma'am. 15.6, sunlight, white or colored. Have you ever seen a rainbow in the sky? You might have noticed that it appears usually after the rain when the sun is low in the sky. The rainbow is seen as a large arc in the sky with many colors. Figure 15.20 to it. How many colors are present in a rainbow? When observed carefully, there are 7 colors in a rainbow, though it may not be easy to distinguish all of them. These are red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo and violet.
You can learn it by the name of Vibgyor. I want each one of you to write down and find out how we can learn the concept Vibgyor. You need to write down V-I-B-Y-G-O-R. Vibgyor. Write down and see the sequence of colors. Start from the last, violet, I for indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. So this is a sequence to be followed in the Vibgyor. Okay. If you need to learn the sequence of the colors, that starts from the back. V for violet, I for indigo, B for it's blue, G for green, Y for
yellow,
O for orange, and R stands for red. Yes, red. Zikra, continue now.
O for orange and L for red.
Yes. Zikra, continue reading.
Okay, ma'am.
You might have seen that.
You might have seen that when you blow a soap bubble, they appear colorful. Similarly, when light is reflected from the surface of a compact disc CD, you see many colors. Figure 15.29. On the basis of these experiences, could we say that the sunlight is a mixture of different colors? Let us investigate.
Okay, thank you, beta. So children, you must have seen the soap bubbles. Soap bubbles, and this see in figure 15.29, we can see the different colors in the CD. I think, have you seen it? And different colors in the scale. Many of
yes,
the children
ma'am.
Were showing me the colors in the scale, even plastic scale. You were able to see the different colors, even in the soap bubbles, even in the oil floating on the water, we are able to see the different colors. So what happens, from where these colors come from? Let's have an activity. 15.11. Yes, Anya Jain, continue.
Okay, ma'am. Take a prism made of glass. Let a narrow beam of sunlight through a small hole in the window of a dark room to fall on one face to the prism. Allow the light coming out of the other face of the prism fall on a white sheet of paper or on a white wall.
Figure side by side, you can see in figure 15.30. A light is falling on a prism. And prism is a triangular shaped transparent object which is made up of glass. This is a prism. When the white light falls on the prism, what happens? It split into 7 colors. So I want each one of you to draw this figure 15.30 also in your notebooks, that how white light split into the different colors. Yes, continue.
On a white sheet of paper or of prism fall on a white sheet of paper or on a white wall. What do you see? You can see colors similar to those in a rainbow. Figure 15.30, this shows that the sunlight consists of 7 colors. The sunlight appears to be white 7 colors. It means that there are 7 colors in white light. Try to identify these colors and write their names in your notebook.
Okay,
can you mix these colors?
Okay, thank you. What will happen if you will mix all these colors? So we have an activity 12 also. If we'll mix all the colors, 7 colors, then what will happen? Yes, continue. Yes, Mukul Jain, continue. Afterwards.
15.12. Take a circular cardboard disc of about 10 centimeter diameter. Divide this disc into 7 segments. Paint the 7 rainbow color on this segment as shown in 15.31. A. You can also paste color paper on this segment. Make a small hole at the center of the disc. Fix the disc loosely on the tip of a refill of a ball pen. Ensure that the disc rotates freely. Rotate the disc in daylight. When the disc is rotated fast, the color get mixed together and the disc appear to the whitish. Such a disc is popularly known as Newton's disc.
Newton's disc. So children, you may see in 15.12 experiment, this experiment is to show that sunlight is made up of 7 colors. So what we need to take, a circular cardboard and divide it into 7 parts. And you can color the 7 parts with different colors, or you can paste the glaze paper of it. And 7 color you have to choose in the way that we have taken in the Vibgyor. Okay. Now in the center, fix that pencil. Yes, beta, yes. Yes, speak out.
In activity 15.12, and we can unburn 15.12, and we can also take any damage or corrupted DVD or CD.
Yes, you can take. You can take. So after that, what we need to do, in the center, I have fixed a pencil. And now I have to rotate that pencil continuously with a fast speed. What will happen if this pencil will be rotating? At that time, we are able to see this color. Means what happens at that time? All the color mixed together and we are able to see only this whitish color or grayish color. It means that white color is made up of 7 different colors. If we are, children, it's very interesting. If we are rotating this disc with a very high speed, we are able to see the whitish or a gray color. That's why we say that sunlight appears to be white, but actually what it is made up of 7 colors. Okay. And 7 colors are the colors of the rainbow. I hope it's clear to you. This experiment was given by the Newton. That's why it is the name of a Newton disc. So you may get the experiment related to it that explained with the help of a Newton disc that sunlight is made up of 7 colors. So I hope each one of you have understood, and even you can do it. There is no any cost for it. You have to take a circular cardboard, only divide it into 7 parts. And after dividing into the 7 parts, you need to color it. It's your wish. You are coloring or you are pasting the different colored sheets in the triangular form and then rotate. Then you are able to see that the sunlight is made up of the white color. So Paheli was a brilliant idea. She has prepared a small top with a small circular disc with the 7 rainbow colors painted on it. When the top rotates, it appears to be nearly white or grayish, we can say. Okay, she has made the top by using the pencil. So you can also try such kind of things. So children, with this, your chapter is over. Now, I hope each one of you have understood. There is no issues. And after that, we'll come to the back exercise. If any of the problem is there, you may ask regarding the chapter. Okay, children, let's continue the back exercise now. And first question is your filling the blanks. An image that can't be obtained on a screen is called, that is known as a
virtual image
formed by convex dash
mirror
is mirror. Always virtual. It's
mirror.
Next, image formed by dash mirror is always same as the size of the object.
Plane mirror.
Next is plane mirror. No image, an image which can be obtained on a screen, that is known as a
real image.
Real
formed by a dash can't be obtained on a screen. By a concave, you have to fill either a lens or either a mirror.
Lens.
Next, true or false. So you have to mark either it is true or false. We can obtain a large and erect image by a mirror, by a convex mirror.
It is false.
Next,
false.
A concave lens can form a virtual image.
True.
Always form a virtual image. So it is true. We can obtain a real, a large, and inverted image by a concave mirror.
True.
It is true. A real image can't be obtained on a screen.
False.
A concave mirror always form a real image.
False.
Next, you need to match the following columns. First is a plane mirror.
The image is erect and of the same size as the object.
Yes. So match it with the fifth part, A with the fifth. Concave mirror, where we can match.
Mirror can form an image of objects spread over a large area.
Okay, concave mirror can be used by the dentist also. Can be used by the dentist to see the enlarged image of the
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Sorry. This is a convex mirror. This is for concave mirror. Next is convex mirror. Second ka bataiye, convex mirror.
Use as a magnifying glass.
And form image of objects.
Use as a magnifying glass. Yes. Dobara se bolo beta.
Use as a magnifying glass.
No, beta. Convex mirror I am talking about. Convex mirror that spread over a large area. Convex lens is a magnifying lens.
Ma'am, convex mirror convex can form image of objects spread over a large area.
Yes, now it is a concave lens. Two options are there. 4 and 6 are left. 4 and 6. Concave lens. What does it make? Image is erect, smaller.
Ma'am, the image is erect and smaller in size than the object.
Or one is left, the image is always inverted and magnified. So the sixth is there and fourth is the extra one. Next is, state the characteristics of the image formed by the plane mirror. So children, already we have done the image formed by the plane mirror. Who will give the answer? Vansh Sharma, continue.
Ma'am, plane mirror forms an erect image. Size of the image is same as that object. Image is formed at the same distance behind the mirror as the object stands in front of it. Image formed is inverted right hand side of the object seems to be the left hand side end.
Okay, that's why it is known as lateral inversion. So these are the point. Children, I want this answer to be written in the point wise. Okay. And after that, question number 5, already we have done. Should I erase all that? Have you noted down all the first question, second question and third question? Have you done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next is question number 5. Find out the letters of the English alphabet of any other language known to you, which forms a image in the plane mirror appears exactly the same letters. So children, already we have done, we have written all the alphabets of English letter.
And the letters like A, H, I, M, O, T, U, V, W appear same when the plane mirror.
Yes.
So ma'am, can I tell the same answer?
No, next we'll continue. About the 10 letters are there which are show the same image in the plane mirror. Next is question number 6. What is a virtual image? Give one situation where the virtual image is formed. Kindly raise your hand, children.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Okay, Tanvi. And after next question, Anya, you will tell. Continue.
Okay, ma'am. The image that cannot be obtained on a screen is called a virtual image. The image formed by a plane mirror is virtual.
Okay, very good. So, our simplest example she has given. Good. Number 7, Anya. State two difference between the convex and concave lens.
Convex lens. It is thicker in the middle and thinner at the edges. Converges the light falling on it. Can form virtual, erect and magnified image. Concave lens. It is thinner in the middle and thicker at the edges. Diverges the light falling on it and always form erect, virtual and smaller image.
Very good. So though she has given the differences and children, you may draw the diagram also for the convex lens and a concave lens. Next, give one use each of the following, like a concave and convex mirror. So already we have done 3 of the uses of concave and convex mirror. You know that is used as a rear view mirror. Next, which type of mirror can form a real image? Tell me.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Yes.
A concave mirror can form a real image.
Yes, simply concave mirror can form a real image. Number 10, which type of lens forms always a virtual image? Konsa lens jo hai wo hamesha virtual
concave lens.
Concave lens.
Whenever you are doing it, you need to take care whether it has been asked for the lenses or whether it has been asked for the mirror. So I want each one of you to do these questions and rest you are that are the MCQs. A virtual image always larger. Image larger than
a concave mirror.
May be produced by a
mirror.
Concave mirror. A David is observing his image in a plane mirror. The distance between the mirror and the image is 4 meters. If he moves 1 meter towards the mirror, children, now you have to take care of it. The distance between
3 meters.
The distance between the mirror and
6 meters.
6 meters.
It will be 6. Aapko pata hai, the distance is 4 meters. If 1 meter, the distance will be reduced. So the distance between the is image will be at 6 meters. Next, you have to find it out. A rear view mirror of a car is a plane mirror. A driver is reversing his car at the speed of 2 meters per second. The driver sees his rear mirror, the image of a truck parked behind the speed of which. Okay, tell me what can be the
4 meters per second.
4 meters square.
No, it will be 2 meters per second. Aapse speed puchhi gayi hai. The speed of which the image the truck appears to approach the driver will be 2 meters per second. Okay. So children, this was a questions and you know that these questions will remain in the book and rest of the questions you have to do in the notebook. So with this, your chapter number 15 is over.